This episode of the John LeBang Show is brought to you by Banger for President 2016.
Yeah, when the two-party system leaves you feeling ill deep down, then you only have one option.
Vote for none of the above, man,
or else you'll get the runs.
Banger 2016.
I'm John LeBang, and I approve this message.
Welcome to the only hour that's spreading like wildfire. I'm your host, John LeBang, here for yet another 60 minutes of broadcasting excellence right here on your favorite radio station. And there's a lot of those favorite radio stations that I'm on now. That's right, ladies and gentlemen. Over the past week, we've gained so many radio stations, I've lost track. I can't keep count of it anymore. And I'd like to welcome all you brand new listeners to the broadcast. Everyone who's listening in on 920 WON The Apple in New York. All of you wonderful people over at the 365 Radio Network. Everybody who's listening to this very first broadcast on 24.7 The Stream. And of course, we're not forgetting you over at Code Zero Radio in Utah. Or anybody over at Vulcan Sound Radio or WRFN 1025 or our home station Alien X Radio. And if this is your first helping of the John LeBang Show, let me explain a little bit of what goes on here. This is kind of a variety show. We do a multitude of things. Some nights we're going to talk about the news. Other nights we're going to have skits or comedy. We're going to have bands in here to do interviews. You're going to hear local bands and unsigned artists from all over the world. Every once in a while on this broadcast, you're going to hear some radio drama. And some nights you're going to hear my opinions. And I have very strong views and opinions. So this show is not the same old, same old. You're not going to get the cookie cutter shows that almost every other station has. Because we don't want to stick to one thing. And we know our audience loves the diversity in the content of this broadcast. They expect it and demand it. And again, if this is the first time you're listening to The John LeBang Show, I'm asking you to give us about 6 weeks. Take it in slowly, because you're really not going to be used to this style of broadcasting. So take about 6 weeks to get a taste of the show, to understand the flavor of the show. Think of us as fine coffee. And when you first had coffee, when you were younger, it tasted kind of bitter. But after you tried it a few times, you realized not only did you like it, but it gave you some benefits. You had more energy and you felt good. And you could get going in the morning. Well, the John LeBang Show is very similar. The more you listen to the John LeBang Show, the more you're going to like this broadcast. And as we say here, listening to this broadcast causes chronic brain cell rejuvenation. And I'm sure after giving us some time and understanding what we do here, you're going to become a loyal listener, just like all the other listeners on all the other stations. Now, while you're listening to the broadcast and you want to learn more about the John LeBang Show, you can go to my website. That's www.jlebang.com. If you have comments and you're not able to get to one of the chat rooms,
because we're in just about every one of the chat rooms out there,
then send us an email at jlebang@live.com and tell us what you think of the show.
Hey, John, you got any beer?
Shady, I'm in the middle of a show.
Well, I'm sorry.
That's okay.
Well, do we got any beer?
No, I have to get some.
Well, you want me to run to the store?
Sure, Shady.
Okay, I'll do that. You want anything?
No, I'm good.
All right, then.
Sorry about that, folks. So with the business out of hand, let's get into some of the broadcast one. Some big news comes out of the NHL this week, as the NHL has decided to add a 31st team, and it's going to be in Las Vegas, and they are going to start in 2017-2018. So not the season coming up, but the season after. We're going to have a brand new NHL franchise in Las Vegas. Because apparently they're used to cold weather, sports in Las Vegas. Gary Bettman said the NHL Board of Governors unanimously accepted an expansion bid from Sin City on Wednesday, with the new team set to begin play in 2017 and 2018. Quote, "We think this is a tremendously exciting opportunity, not just for Las Vegas, but for the league," said Bettman. "The expansion comes at a time when our game is more competitive than ever. Ownership is stronger than ever, and the player base is more talented than ever, and the business and the future opportunities for the business are greater than ever." And apparently the NHL and Gary Bettman and the Board of Governors think that it's good to just bring in one hockey team. Team already had 30, and you're going to bring in one hockey team, and that's going to help the league in some manner. Of course, it did cost the new team $500 million paid to all the other NHL owners and the league. $500 million to join the league. Just give up $500 million to join a second-rate hockey league. And I know there's a lot of NHL fans out there, and I'm a big hockey fan. I love the Detroit Red Wings. I'm based here in Detroit. So why wouldn't I love the Red Wings? But honestly, $500 million for an NHL hockey team, just so you have the right to be part of the league and you can pick 27 players. In fact, the NHL is now going to add 27 more NHL player jobs. Maybe a little less, but you know, you're talking with some guys bouncing up and down from the minors and stuff. Roughly 27 new NHL player jobs.
I sing at Penn when the puck come down.
They take in $500 million.
Bang, you know, before the other guys, now those, nobody there. You
now
know.
Those 27 players that are going to be added to the league couldn't make teams last year with 30 teams. Because you're not going to just miraculously come up with, oh, say, superstar players to plop in at the top of all these teams. These players aren't just going to come out of nowhere.
Ice sticking happen when...
And you're going to have automatic more superstars, 27 more superstars, not even three or four more superstars.
The guy take the stick, you know, and he
Because you have a new team.
Like that, you know, you don't
you're
do that.
You're actually pulling from the guys that didn't make the NHL last year.
Against the rules.
They didn't make a team.
You know, you're stupid when you do
so
that.
So now,
just some English
to give them a job... Kind of like McDonald's or something.
Slashing is like that.
To give them a job.
And for a trip also, you know.
Oh.
Like
they
that. And mm-hmm. for hook like
create
this.
A new franchise.
For spear, you know.
Out in Las Vegas.
All bad.
Where all the betting happens. How is that going to work, NHL? How is that going to work? You have a team in Las Vegas, the gambling capital of the world, and how often does that city bet on hockey? Maybe not a lot, I don't know. Like I said earlier, hockey's kind of a second-rate sport. It's not like hockey's football or baseball or even basketball. Like I said before, golf and NASCAR draw more people and are considered bigger sports, and it costs $500 million to get in the NHL, apparently. In 2000, which is 16 years ago, it only cost teams $80 million to get into the league. That was Columbus and Minnesota. So to dilute the league even more, because I don't believe what Gary Bettman said was true. I don't believe the NHL is better with more teams. But congratulations to everybody out there in Las Vegas who's getting a hockey team. I know that's a very exciting thing to get a hockey team. But looking at it as a hockey fan, I can't see the benefit in having an extra team. We're having teams that are out in the desert already struggling. I'm not sure why you think bringing in another team, one team, which boggles my mind in general, because if you're going to add teams to the league, shouldn't you add two, since Don't we want to keep an even league? So now we have an odd league. We have an odd number. 31 teams. But this board of governors, this commissioner who's been commissioner since I can remember, I mean, he's been there forever, Gary Bettman. Most of the things that him and the people in charge of the NHL think are going to make the game better, an old-time hockey fan like myself, I don't buy it. I don't see it. They've done all they could to get rid of fighting in the hockey league. And when you see a fight in, when you're at a game and you see a fight, the fans go wild. It's crazy. Everybody likes it. You never see somebody going, oh, is that terrible? Can't they just play some hockey like nice little boys? You never hear that. But no, Gary Bettman and everybody running the NHL thinks that fighting is bad. So because fighting is bad, they've been working to get rid of that. Getting rid of the tie, going to this overtime loss, and giving a point for a losing team who loses in overtime. And then your standings, of course, are going to look like there's parity in the league when people get points for losing. Oh, you made it to overtime. We'll give you a point because you lost. Oh, you can't finish the game? Let's go to a shootout and determine a whole game on a stupid shootout. So as we can see, the NHL commissioner and the Board of Governors have made some wonderful decisions. We had the glowing puck. I believe that was Gary Bettman who was involved with that. The NHL and its Board of Governors make fabulous decisions that do wonders for us longtime hockey fans. The new icing rule. I used to love when guys would race down to try to beat out the icing. But no, not anymore. Because it's automatic icing now. Gets to the red line. Guy just kind of, oh, I'll just let it go. Oh! I really tried to get to it, but I just couldn't make it. The only reason there's parity in the league is because they've imposed a salary cap, which took all the power out of the good teams. The teams that wanted to build winners took all the power out of their hands. If you wanted to build a winner before the salary cap, all you had to do was build a winner by spending the money. Go and buy the players, spend money on players, and you'll get them to come. But the NHL thought that was unfair. All the losing teams, the teams that never wanted to spend the big money, they thought that was unfair. We don't want to spend all our money? Are you kidding me? We don't want to spend tons of money to build a winning hockey team. That's absurd. So we get the salary cap that was supposed to help the teams make money, and it took them forever to make money. Because as soon as the first salary cap went into place, it only took a couple years, and the salaries were going right back to where they were. Then we had the lockout a few years ago. I don't know if you guys remember that lockout a few years ago. Players were getting too much money again or something. I don't even remember what the damn excuse was. But regardless, it's supposed to keep the money down or something. And when they came back, oh boy, we're going to just sign guys for these long, stupid contracts. And get stuck with long, stupid contracts. And now we want to buy guys out. Now we have to trade contracts away when they retire. And we're stuck with a stupid contract. Like Ken Holland signed a 3-year deal with Pavel Datsyuk. That's another thing that just happened in the NHL. Since we're talking hockey, Pavel Datsyuk skips out on his contract a year early to go back to be in Russia. And I blame that on Ken Holland. Because apparently, from all the news sources that I've been reading, Ken Holland knew that Datsyuk only wanted to play 1 year when he signed him for 3. Datsyuk knew it. Holland knew it. And Datsyuk played that first year in his contract. He wanted to retire after that. Go back to Russia. I shouldn't say retire, but he wanted to go back and play in Russia, be with his daughter. And Ken Holland
the genius that he is, has to beg Datsyuk to play one more year, a second year on that contract. Please, Pavel, play one more year. Please! Pavel misses, the first 20 games or so, comes back, and he's, definitely not the Pavel he used to be. But that's the Red Wings for you. The team that made the Michigan taxpayers pay $200, $250 million towards their new arena, and they've got a hockey team that's not only on the decline, but now that Datsyuk is retired, they look like they're going to be hanging out with Buffalo. Toronto just got a brand new goalie, Frederik Andersen. Just with that move and the loss of Datsyuk, Toronto's better than Detroit. And I guess some Canadian team has got to get better, because none of them made the playoffs last year. Not one of them. I wonder how that makes a Canadian feel, that not one hockey team represented Canada in the Stanley Cup playoffs at all. Zero. Their sport has been completely taken away by the U.S. And in the U.S., it's a what? Oh, it's a second-rate sport. It's not even a first-rate sport. So the Canadians couldn't even hold on to a second-rate sport in their own country, their own game. And I love the game. I grew up sitting next to my grandfather watching the Montreal Canadiens every Saturday. Dun, 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 on Hockey Night in Canada. Watching Toronto when Montreal wasn't on. Every once in a while getting to see the Red Wings, because my grandfather didn't enjoy the Red Wings as much as Montreal, but that's because he was born in Quebec and Montreal was his team. So now all these years have passed since I was a kid, and I've watched a lot of transformations in hockey. In the last 10 or so, 15 years, I don't know, the last 10 years at least, what I've seen from the NHL is a bunch of, not very good stuff. They want parity, but what that really means, ladies and gentlemen, is they want a bunch of below-average teams. And the only reason they added a 31st team is because they're not making the money they want to make. They want to be a first-rate sport. They act like a first-rate sport, but they're not. They're a second-rate sport. And they're not making the money they want to, so they bring in a team for $500 million. Hey, thanks a lot. Thanks a lot. We know your team's going to stink. And in about 4, 5, 6 years in Vegas, you're probably going to have financial problems. And you'll probably have to change owners once or twice in the next 10 years. But hey, give us your $500 million. We'll make you part of the league, because our league ain't very good and we need a little help with money.
You do that, you go to the box,
Because our owners are greedy, and so are the players. Everybody wants to act like a first-rate sport, even though we're not.
2 minutes by yourself.
And anything good about the league has almost been thrown out the window.
You feel shame.
Oh, there's the music. Break time already, just when I was getting started.
And then you get free.
You're listening to the John LeBang Show.
Join the radio revolution right here.
It's better than some good tie stick, man.
Yes, I would like some too.
And if you'd like to find out what times and days the John LeBang Show is played on your favorite station, then please refer yourself to my website. That's www.jlebang.com. Look for the schedule at link, click on that, and you'll be able to find your favorite radio station and the time we are on it. It's so exciting, isn't it?